Today, we have something a little different. We are going to discuss idioms, everyone's favorite, maybe, that have to do with dogs, also everyone's favorite, right?
I was thinking about this topic last week because it has started to get very hot here where we are. And we have this expression, the dog days of summer. So I started thinking, well, there's a lot of expressions that have to do with dogs.
In fact, I will just tell you what the dog days of summer means. It just means the hottest part of summer. Oh, Janja has a dog.
Oh.
Now I am distracted. I can't.
Tell us the name of your dog.
Her name is Sitsi. She has, I think 5 or 6 years old.
She's a
Chihuahua.
I can tell she's a Chihuahua from those ears.
Yeah.
And her size.
Very small. All right.
She looks like a puppy.
Yes. She's a little bit like kind of nervous with the rain. Today is raining cats and dogs.
Oh.
Good.
Well, everyone knows this dog idiom for sure.
Yes.
Excellent work. So yes. Well, let's go to that one first. Raining cats and dogs just means it's raining so hard. And I just looked up the meaning of this, or the origin of this, I should say. Apparently, it comes from a Greek expression, kata doxa or something, and it just means really strong or intensely. Yeah. So it's just like wordplay that we say cats and dogs. It just sounds similar to a Greek expression.
So that means that it's a very strong rain. Yeah. Another expression we use for that is it's coming down in buckets.
Yes.
Okay, so I'm going to write the next one here.
Oh, God. Just interrupt.
God.
So now Yansha has a cat and a dog. And it's raining cats and dogs.
We have
nice guests today.
Yes.
Okay, so here's the next expression, the dog days of summer.
Oh, get rid of the S there.
Oh.
Dog days of summer. So dog days of summer. This just means the hottest part of summer, as we said. And it actually takes place here and many places in the Northern Hemisphere in like July and August. And in fact, the reason that this is an expression, I always thought it was because when it's really hot, dogs are lazy. That's what I thought was the meaning of this expression. But it actually has to do with astronomy and the stars.
Yeah,
so the brightest Sirius, the dog star, it's the brightest star during those months in the constellation, Canis Major, the big dog constellation in the sky. So that's where it comes from. But really, it feels like the dog days of summer here in Washington from like June to October.
Sometimes even in May.
Yeah. Very hot and uncomfortable.
It's a semi-tropical area, I think.
So before we move on, Xianja had a great example of a common dog idiom, but does anyone else want to share some that they already know in English so we can learn from each other. Toki, yeah.
Yeah, I've heard about this expression, it's a dog eat dog word.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Yes, dog eat dog world.
Yeah.
Do you want to explain it?
Yeah, so basically it is describing a situation where people are, where people would do anything to succeed in life.
Mm-hmm. Or do anything to win or to, yes. So it's just, it describes a very competitive environment. Another expression that is similar to it is win at all costs. So do whatever you can do to be successful or win, no matter the consequences or the effects. Yeah, mm-hmm. That's a very good one. Adriana?
Oh, hello. Let's live in Russia.
That is one as well. Your sound is a little bit difficult to hear today, but I got enough words. So just leave the situation as it is. Don't bother. Mm-hmm. Or don't do too much to make a situation worse, possibly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So let sleeping dogs lie. I'll write that down.
Yeah. So the situation is okay as it is. Don't disturb anything. Sanjay, what happens if your dog is asleep and you try to wake her up?
She stands up and go away.
She's to find some quieter place.
Not terribly happy.
The other dog, I have two dogs. The other dog see you like, why are you bothering me? I was sleeping well.
I was having a great dream.
Yes. Dreaming about food.
I love seeing the dogs when their feet move in their sleep. They're chasing a rabbit or something.
this example might be used if. Or this idiom might be used if you're having an argument with someone or a fight and you want to try to fix it, but it maybe isn't the right time to fix it. So you might tell yourself or your friend, like, let's sleeping dogs lie. Let sleeping dogs lie. Nothing is going to get better right now.
All right, so want to try another one? How about every dog has its day? Have you heard this expression? Chem, you've got your hand up. Would you like to explain that one?
I want to give another example.
Okay.
Sick and a dog.
Sick as a dog.
Sick as a dog.
Yeah. I think it's historical phrases. Before.
I got it.
I think lack of careness and healthy dogs are very bad situation at history. Maybe people put this phrase, I guess.
Well,
yes,
I think when before there was a treatment for rabies, right? When a dog would get this disease, rabies, and bite someone, then they would become very sick.
Oh, is that where it comes from?
Because you know it makes a white foam around the mouth of a dog when they have rabies, and people get very sick when they get bit. But now there's of course, a medical treatment for it. And dogs, I think, can be vaccinated against it, so they don't get it anymore. So.
Yeah. Sick as a dog. Yeah, another very common expression. You will notice that a lot of these expressions in American English, even though we love our dogs, they don't have a very positive meaning. Like, unfortunate.
But do we have a positive expression about dogs?
No.
How about the one I just said? Every dog has its day.
That's a little more positive. Has anyone heard of this one? No. So this means that everyone has a period of success in their life. So even people who might consider themselves unlucky will one day have some luck and experience success. That's what it means. It can be used to encourage someone who is feeling a little hopeless or a little upset about their current situation. You might tell your friend or someone who is going through something similar to that, oh, every dog has its day. It just means things will get better, kind of, right?
Mm-hmm.
A little bit. One day. Yeah. Yeah.
That reminds me of another expression. Somebody can be described as being the top dog in an organization.
Oh, there's a more positive.
So maybe we could say Jem is the top dog in his unit. If he's kind of the boss, right?
Yeah.
He would be called the top dog. Because dogs have a very strict social structure, right? They know who's the boss. Top dog, yeah. Right. I think it's time for me to erase my board because I've got too many things on here.
So we have taught a lot of dog idioms very quickly. And we want to know if in your native language, are there a lot of dog idioms, and can you explain one to us?
Sancha? Well, here in Spanish, when someone is really, really sick, we say it coughs, cough of dog, like
cough.
A very strong cough.
Cough. Uh-huh. Okay.
The cough of a dog.
Uh-huh. Have you ever heard a dog cough?
It's
noisy.
It's noisy, and when dogs have a cough, it's kind of serious.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Maybe a major health problem. Yeah. Interesting.
So when someone has a really strong cough, we say that he coughs like a dog.
Cough, cough. Can you check the pronunciation when cough. You say cough, put your lip against your teeth like that.
Cough.
Cough. Cough. Maria has her hand up. What's your question?
Yes. Life as a dog. Your life as a dog. Because that means that is very... unfortunately, a poor life. And then it used to do to say that in Spanish.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, really? It's a poor life.
Yes, a poor life. Life as a dog.
In English, we say it's a dog's life.
It's a dog life. Yes, yes. And because poor life.
Mm-hmm.
I always thought that meant that it was a good life. In English, is that right?
A good life, yes.
Well, I think it started out to mean the same thing as Maria is explaining, kind of a poor, difficult, unfortunate life.
Indeed. But yes.
Yeah. But now I think, well, a lot of dogs lead good lives if they are pets. So we use it in a more positive way now. It's a dog's life. But it definitely began... In meaning the same thing. Yeah. Toki, what about in your native language.
Yeah, so here in Madagascar, we describe people that that can't be serious, even in very serious situation. We tell them that they are like dogs.
Oh.
Yeah.
So they're not. So you're like a dog. Okay.
Yeah.
Interesting. I'm gonna start. I'm going to start using that. So if someone is not taking a serious situation seriously, then you can say you are being, you have to say you are like a dog, or can you say, is it like you are being a dog?
Yeah, I think you can say both.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right. Interesting. And I think we have that, but it's a slightly different meaning when we say someone's acting like a dog. In American English, sometimes it means that it's maybe you're not taking relationships seriously.
Oh.
Like romantic relationships. Right?
Oh, and we can only say this about men.
Yeah, yeah, he's such a dog. It kind of means he doesn't treat women very well, right?
Oh, yeah, that's a different meaning. But yeah. Again, not a very happy example of what a dog is. How about Imad?
Yes. We have an example in our culture, okay? Uh-huh. It says, tail of dog not straight, not be straight, not become straight. Tail of dog not become straight.
The tail of a dog.
Yes.
Will not become straight, okay?
Yes, yes. It's describe bad behaviors of someone.
So maybe bad behavior will not change.
When someone talk in bad behaviors or make false something, someone describe him. It is like the tail of the dog. Yes, Dr. Jen. Yes, you understand me, Ashley?
Yes, yes. It reminds.
Go ahead. Yes. It describe bad behaviors of someone.
Yeah. So this reminds me of an expression we have. I'm going to write it down. It's long. It can be used in this way to kind of, you can't fix someone's bad habits or bad behavior. And that expression is, you can't teach an old dog new tricks. This means people are slow to change their ways. Yeah, for example, perhaps some of you have tried to teach your parents how to use the internet. Maybe not Janja. Claudius. Probably not. Yeah. Or grandparents to use the internet. And it's just a very slow, kind of frustrating process. You might say, oh, you can't teach an old dog new tricks. But also,
Toki had his hand up.
Yeah, I found one that is more positive here in Madagascar. So it is when you meet a very cute baby, you just say, oh, this baby is cute as a dog. He's as cute as a puppy dog.
Oh.
See, if you, I agree with that. If a baby's cute, I want to say that. But in English, if you told a new mother or father that their baby was cute as a dog, they would get mad. That's a funny one.
Yeah, I agree.
I like that one. So before we were explaining the you can't teach an old dog new tricks. You also hear it when someone changes their ways or learns something new, and maybe people did not expect them to do that. People will say, "Oh, I guess you can teach an old dog new tricks." So it's mm-hmm. kind of proving someone wrong, proving that you can, mm-hmm. in fact, mm-hmm. learn something or change a bad behavior or just a not very effective behavior, let's say. uh-huh. So.
All right. You ready for another one? How about this one?
Oh.
In the doghouse. What do you think this one means?
So often if owners of a dog have a backyard or a back area of their house, their dog will have a little small house, like a little shelter area. What do you think that might mean? If someone is in the doghouse.
Often this will be describing a man in a relationship with his wife. If the wife is angry at her husband.
That is often how it was used, yeah. It can be used in other ways as well.
Yeah, maybe at work somebody could be in the doghouse.
For example, let's say I come in to work late every day. Completely false example, let's say. every day of the week. And Dr. Jill might tell me, actually, if you keep being late, you're going to be in the doghouse. Does that help maybe help you guess what it might mean? No. So it's just, Imad's like, just tell.
Keep going.
So in the doghouse is just another way of saying to be in trouble. So I'm not sure why we have this expression. It's almost as if in a family, if a child or partner, husband, wife, whatever, if they are acting or behaving badly, maybe they get sent out to sleep in the doghouse outside. I don't know. That's probably where it comes from.
But it's what we say in Spanish.
Oh, okay.
In Spanish, we say that. We say, if you are behaving bad with another person, you are going to sleep in the dog's house.
Oh, so you have the actual verb to sleep in it as well. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In Spanish, yes, we have that expression.
We have shortened it in English, I guess. But it means, we think of the same thing. Yeah.
We also have sleeping on the sofa.
Yeah, we also have that. We also have that. And when we want to emphasize, we'd say, and the dog's house.
Mm-hmm. Good. Thank you.
Maybe.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
We have another in Spanish. A dog with two tails. When you are very happy.
Oh.
You see my dog with two tails.
Yeah.
Do you have one in English?
No. The tail reveals how happy the dog is, right?
Yeah.
Ah, we do have an expression about tails, though.
Yeah.
Do you remember, Ashley?
The tail wags the dog or something like that? What is it?
We have wag the dog, which means the tail wags the dog.
Yeah.
But we also have, if you go home with your tail between your legs. So somebody who goes away with their tail between their legs.
Can you back it up and move it to your left? There.
Okay. So what do you think this means? To go away with your tail between your legs. Imagine a dog doing that. Sanjay?
Well, here in Mexico we use also that expression. It's we mean that it's just like something gets wrong and you, well, when a dog is scared, the dog runs with a tail between their legs.
Yeah.
So it means something like that, that you are running away. Yes.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And then actually there's a word in English. Let me write this down too. You are humiliated. You see that?
Yes.
If you have your tail between your legs, you're humbled or humiliated.
Embarrassed, ashamed. Any of
them. Yeah. Toki, did you have a similar expression? Had your hand?
No, I was about to speak about this expression, having the tail between the legs, and actually it is the same that Claudia or Sandra told. Yeah, it was the same situation. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, that means to be scared of something and running away. Yeah, that's what it means in my country. Yeah.
Uh-huh. What is your native language?
Yeah, so my native language is Malagasy.
Uh-huh.
Malagasy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can I say something?
Yes.
Have you discussed the expression, because I had to leave for a moment, have you discussed the expression tired as a dog?
Tired as a dog? No.
Yeah. We have the same in Spanish.
It was not successful.
Well, we saw Dublin. It's very cute. or dog tired. We would say dog tired.
Dog tired?
Yeah. Can you tell us a time when you were dog tired?
Yes, I remember one day I was, I had days off and I was not at home. And when I came, the home was robbed. And to repair and to arrange all the things in its place, after I finished, I was, how do you say, dog tired?
Dog tired, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It was a long journey.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have a question, but the problem is it has to do and it has not to do with the things we are talking about. I want to know, because one day you discussed in English in a minute the expression, let the settle down. Let the dust settle. And I want to know, what's the difference between let the dust settle and let sleeping dogs lie?
That's a very good question, and they are very similar. I guess I would say let the dust settle means more to let wait until you try to address a problem, whereas let sleeping dogs lie more means don't try to deal with the problem maybe at all. But they are very similar. And did we do let the dust settle in English in a minute?
Yeah, you did.
A good one. So we forgot to mention that this, these expressions that we have taught, most of them are in a Words and Their Stories article that Dr. Jill can send
I'll put it in the chat here.
That Anna Mateo wrote, or at least produced.
Voiced.
And produced. So you can hear more examples in that article. I think we covered a lot of them, but there are so many more dog idioms. Yeah, and thank you for sharing some of your dog phrases in your languages. Spanish, Egyptian, Arabic, Malagasy. It's very cool. All right.
Bye, we learned a lot too.
Yeah.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
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 Thank you. Thank you very much.
See you later.
Thank you.
See you later.